स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अ न्यू चैप्टर. द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज एसिड्स, बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट. दिस वन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर स्टूडेंट्स, एंड ऑलमोस्ट 60-70% ऑफ सिलेबस ऑफ केमिस्ट्री इज टॉपिक फ्रॉम एसिड, बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट. स्टूडेंट्स, मैं आपको बता दूं, एसिड, बेसिस, सॉल्ट बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक है एट द पॉइंट ऑफ एग्जामिनेशन स्टूडेंट्स. So we must focus here all the things. Okay, so let me start first the term here, acids. Students, सबसे पहला यहाँ पे हम लोग देखते हैं क्या acids है क्या. As the name suggests, students, acid, it is derived from Latin word. It is derived from Latin word. Latin word acidus, acidus, which means sour in taste, which means sour in taste. Students, जिस चीज को खाने में कैसा खट्टा लगे वो समझ जाओ आप क्या है, acid है. Simple सा हम लोग बोल सकते हैं, it is derived from Latin word acidus, which means what, sour in taste. जिस भी चीज को हम खा रहे हो और वो खाने में हमें खट्टा लग रहा हो तो निश्चित तौर पे वो कैसा एसिड, क्या है वो, एसिड है, नंबर एक. लेकिन दिस वन इज नॉट अ डेफिनेशन ऑफ एसिड. हियर हाउ वी डिफाइन एसिड, तो एसिड इज अ सच अ कंपाउंड व्हेन इट मिक्सेस विथ देयर वाटर देन इट आयोनाइज्ड देयर एच प्लस आयन और यू से हाइड्रोनियम आयन. सो सी, क्या मैंने कहा कि एसिड एक ऐसा कंपाउंड है जब उसको वाटर के साथ ऐड किया जाए तो आयोनाइज्ड हो जाए, किस में, हाइड्रोनियम आयन में. बेसिकली लेट्स सी, सपोज आई एम गिविंग वन एग्जांपल, HCl व्हेन मिक्सेस विथ देयर वाटर देन इट गिव्स H प्लस और Cl माइनस एन हाइड्रोजन आयन. Basically, it contains hydrogen, that is proton. Now, HCl, when mixes with their water, then it dissociates H3O plus ion, that is hydronium ion, and Cl minus ion strands. So, what we see here? We see here, whenever an acid mixes with their water, then it's ionize their what, hydronium ion. So whenever they ionize hydronium ion, then it is termed as what, acid. So always acid contain hydronium ion. This one is a fact, students, always you keep in mind. Now give another example, H2SO4 when added with their water, then it ionize hydronium ion H3O plus as well as what, SO4 to minus. Here students, see what I am saying here. I am saying here, when a sulfuric acid H2SO4 mixes with their water, then it ionizes their hydronium ion and what, SO4 to minus ion, students. So always you keep in mind, so whenever an acid mixes with their water, then it always dissociates their hydronium ion, students. Now here the term acid is clear. So acid is such a compound, whenever mixes with their water, then it always ionizes hydronium ion. Now students, if the term acid is clear, then here classification of acid. So students, now we start the classification of acid. So see students, how we classify acid. See, classification of acid. Now students, see here, classification क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ए सीड्स. हियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी कैन क्लासिफाई ए सीड ऑन वेरियस सोर्सेस. नंबर वन, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सोर्सेस. फर्स्ट वी कैन क्लासिफाई ए सीड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सोर्सेस. सो सी, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सोर्सेज स्टूडेंट्स, देर आर टू टाइप ऑफ ए सीड्स. वन इज देयर ऑर्गेनिक ए सीड एंड सेकेंड वन इज इनऑर्गेनिक ए सीड. लेट्स सी, नंबर वन इज व्हाट? ऑर्गेनिक ए सीड. एज अ नेम सजेस्ट स्टूडेंट, ऑर्गेनिक मीन्स व्हाट? लिविंग. सो द ए सीड विच डिराइव फ्रॉम बेसिकली प्लांट्स और एनिमल्स. सो इफ द ए सीड विच इज डिराइव फ्रॉम प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स, देन इट इज टर्म्ड एज ऑर्गेनिक ए सीड. ऑर्गेनिक ए सीड वो ए सीड जो किससे डिराइव हो रहा हो, प्लांट से और या फिर एनिमल से. तो वैसे एसिड को हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं? ऑर्गेनिक एसिड बोलते हैं. देखिए, ध्यान से हम लोग यहाँ पे देखेंगे. सपोज आई एम गिविंग एन एग्जांपल ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक एसिड, दैट इज यू से एग्जांपल ऑक्सैलिक एसिड. ऑक्सैलिक एसिड, सी हियर आई एम गिविंग वन एग्जांपल of what? Oxalic acid. Oxalic acid. Second one is citric acid. Citric acid, which is basically found in lemon. Oxalic acid is found in orange. Third one is acetic acid. Acetic acid, that is found in basically vinegar. Next, lactic acid. Lactic acid is derived from curd. So these all are the acid which we get from plants or the animals. So if I am saying here, students, the acid which is derived from plants or animals, then it is termed as what? Organic acid. Number one. Second one is inorganic acid. Inorganic acid, or you say mineral acid. As the name suggests, student, inorganic means what? Non-living. So the, or you say the mineral. So the acid which basically derived from minerals, that all acid is what termed as inorganic acid. Or you say the mineral acid, that is salt. So here, friends, I am saying, so the seed which is derived from inorganic material, that seed is termed as what? Mineral acid. So here, example, HCl, hydrochloric acid, H2SO4, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, hydrobromic acid. These all are, etc. These all are what? Inorganic acid. And we all know, friends, all the inorganic acid, or you say the mineral acid, is a strong acid. While the organic acid, that is also called carboxylic acid. This one is also called carboxylic acid. So these all acids are known as what? Weak acid. So on the basis of sources, friends, there are two type of acid. One is their organic acid, second one is what? Inorganic acid. Now friends, now another classification here is take here. Next one, on the basis of strength. Second one is on the basis of strength. On the basis of strength, strengths, there are two type of acid. One is weak acid and second one is a strong acid. Let's see first weak acid. Weak acid means what? Those acid where partially ionization of hydronium ion. So when I'm saying whenever the acid or a compound mixes with their water, then partially ionized hydronium ion. So whenever the partially ionized hydronium ion, then it is termed as weak acid. So all organic acid is termed as what? Weak acid, as I previous told. So here, take one example. I am saying here, formic acid, HCOOH, which is present in ant testing. चींटी के काटने में जो एसिड्स होता है ना, that acid is termed as what? Formic acid. The formula is what? HCOOH. So here, see, HCOOH, here, hydrogen, and this one is also hydrogen. So only this hydrogen, carboxylic acid, whatever the hydrogen present in their carboxylic, then that hydrogen is what dissociates, not their saturated compounds. So here, students, I am saying whenever a partially dissociation, not complete dissociation of their hydrogen ion, or you say the hydronium ion, then it is termed as what? Weak acid. Number one. Number two, acetic acid, CH3COOH. This one is also what? Weak acid. So, weak acid, formic acid, acetic acid, oxalic acid also you take. So that all acid is termed as what? Weak acid. Why I am saying weak acid? Because whenever it mixes with their water, then it partially dissociation of their hydronium ion. So once it be partially dissociation of their hydronium ion, then it is termed as weak acid. Now, second one is a strong acid. I am saying what? Strong acid. When I am saying a strong acid, कब कहेंगे strong acid होगा? Let's see. Those acid, when mixes with their water and complete ionization of hydronium ion. Take for example here, suppose HCl. When mixes with their water, then H plus or Cl minus ion, then here complete ionization of hydrogen ion, then it is termed as, or in another way you also write here H3O plus ion or Cl minus ion. In this way you write, this one is more appropriate. Why? Because this hydrogen chloride, or you say the hydrochloric acid, when mixes with their water, then here complete ionization of hydronium ion na. Jab acid, hydrochloric acid, water ke saath mix hua, to yahan pe hydronium ion kya hua? Complete ionization hua. Tab jaakar hum kahenge ise kya? Ye kaisa acid hai? Strong acid hai. Always keep in mind, we say what? In generally, we say hydronium ion. How this hydronium ion form? Well, once the H2O react with their H plus ion, then it gives what? H3O plus ion. So, in generally, a question may be asked in examination that you have to write the formation of hydronium ion. So, see here, students. Formation of hydronium ion is very simple. See here. Here, oxygen, here see, two pair of electron, that is a lone pair of oxygen, mixes with their H plus, then it gives what? This one. OH3-. Here students, hydronium ion. They have two lone pair is there of oxygen atom, and this one is what? Hydrogen plus ion. So this one is what? Hydronium ion. So hydronium ion is formed by the combination of water and hydrogen plus iron. So what type of bond is here? Here the bond is, or in another way also write in this form, in this way also you form in arrow marked, because this one is a coordinate bond, or you see the coionic bond is formed here, so you mark here arrow. So here hydronium ion is formed. So if the question asks in examination, you have to be right the formation of hydronium ion, then this way you have to be right, in this way. But whenever the structure you have to withdraw hydronium ion, then this one is thing that you have to be right. But whenever the question asks, you have to write the formation of hydronium ion, then in this way you have to be right as well. So classification of acid, first on the basis of sources, that is organic and inorganic acid. Second one is on the basis of the strength, that is what? Strong acid as well as weak acid. Now the students, third classification, yes, the third classification of acid. So see here, third classification of acid is, friends, third, on the basis of concentration, on the basis of concentration, concentration ke adhar pe kitne tarah ke acids hum log dekhenge, do. One is the dilute acid, and second one is what? Concentrated acid. So see here students, dilute acid. So what is dilute acid? So let I am clear here. Dilute, it means what? The amount of water is more than the acid. So if I am saying the amount of water is what? More. So here, amount of water is more in acid, then it is termed as what? Dilute acid is called. And when I am saying it is a concentrated acid, concentrated acid students, when I am saying concentrated acid, when the amount of acid is more. So when the amount of acid is more than water, then it is termed as students concentrated acid. So here students, on the basis of concentration, two type of acid, one is there dilute acid, and second one is what? Concentrated acid. So here student, classification of acid on three ways. Firstly, on the basis of sources. Second one, on the basis of strength. Third one, on the basis of concentration. So now the fourth type of acid, on the basis of basicity. So let's see students, the fourth classification of acid is, friends, what I'm saying here, on the basis of basicity strengths, see here, number one, that is monobasic acid. So as a name suggests strengths, monobasic acid, mono means what? One. So what are monobasic acid? Those acid when mixes with their water, then only one hydronium ion ionized there, then it is termed as monobasic acid. Again, I am repeating, students, those a seed when mixes with their water, then it always ionize one hydronium ion. Then it is termed as monobasic acid. Let's see example students here. Suppose HCl, clear, HBr, hydrobromic acid, HI, etc. These all are monobasic acid. How I am saying this one is monobasic acid, students? Let's see. Whenever HCl mixes with their water, then it ionizes H3O plus ion and Cl minus ion. Then how much hydrogen ion ionized here? Only one of the hydrogen ion ionized here, na? So that's why I am saying a monobasic acidic, students. So those acid, whenever mixes with their water and only one of their hydrogen ion is there ionized there, then it is termed as monobasic acidic. In same way, hydrogen bromide, hydrogen iodide, etc., they all contain what? Monobasic acid. Now, second, on the basis of basicity, see, second one is dibasic acid. So as a name suggests, students, dibasic, jaisa ki naam bata raha kya, dibasic acid. So what is dibasic acid? See, students, here when a acid mixes with their water and the two hydronium ion dissociates there, then it is termed as dibasic acid. Let's see. Example, there is what? H2SO4 is what type of acid? Dibasic acid. Getting? So how I am saying here dibasic acid? So see here, H2SO4 mixes with their water, then it dissociates their H3O plus minus HSO4 minus ion. So here the two type of salt is also formed, students. Always keep in mind, one is the acidic salt and second one is normal salt. Let's see here how it is formed. Firstly, whenever the sulfuric acid mixes with their water, then it dissociates their hydronium ion and again the hydrogen sulfate. Here the hydrogen, because here not a complete dissociation, here partially dissociation here take place, students, na? So again this HSO4 mixes with their water, then complete dissociation of their hydronium ion. So here H3O plus and SO4 2 minus ion, students. See, 2 minus ion. So what I am saying here, students, here the two type of acid is formed. One is their acidic salt, and here this one is normal salt. So generally the two type of salt is formed in a dibasic acid. The question may be asked, how many types of salt form at the time of the formation of dibasic acid? So there are two type of salt is formed. One is there acidic salt and second one there is what? Normal salt. Why I am saying acidic salt? Because this one a hydrogen sulfate, this one is also a salt which contain hydrogen ion. So if a salt contain hydrogen ion, then it is termed as what? A acidic salt. And this one is a partially dissociation of their what? Hydrogen ion, na? So that's why I am saying a what? Acidic salt. Getting? And here the complete dissociation of their hydronium ion. So that's why I am saying this one is formed what? Normal salt. So when we discuss that salt, types of salt, then at that time I will told you about the various types of salt, that is acidic salt, basic salt, normal salt, complex salt, double salt. There are so many types of salt. So when we start the salt topic, then I will discuss all the various types of salt strengths. So here, on the basis of first, there are so many types of acids. On the basis of sources, I was told, number one, that is organic acid, and second one is inorganic acid, that is also known as mineral acid. Second one, on the basis of their strength, that is strong acid and weak acid. A strong acid, those acid which complete ionization of their hydronium ion. So whenever the complete ionization of the hydronium ion students, then we see what a strong acid. Previously I was told that is example of HCl, H2SO4, HBr, that all are strong acid students. So on the basis of the strength. Third one, on the basis of concentration. On the basis of concentration, two type of acid, dilute acid and concentrated acid. When I am saying dilute acid, the dilute acid, whenever the amount of water is more than the acid. So if the amount of water is more than the acid, then it is termed as dilute acid. And when I am saying the amount of acid is more than the water, then it is termed as concentrated acid. Now, last one, that is the fourth, on the basis of basicity strengths. On the basis of basicity, number one, that is what monobasic acidic, dibasic acidic, and third one is also here, student, that is a tribasic acid. Let's see, third one is here also. Third one acid is also here, student, that is a tribasic acid. Tri basic acid. As the name suggests, student, this one is what? Tri basic. So tri means what? Three. So if the three hydronium ion be ionized whenever it mixes with the water, then it is termed as tri basic acid. Take an example here, H3PO4. So here, how much hydrogen ion dissociates here? 3 hydrogen hydronium ion, you say here, 3 hydronium ion ionized here, then it is termed as what? Tribasic acidic, students. So in this video we discuss here, students, acid, types of acid. Now in next video, students, we start the preparation of acid, how we prepare acid. So thank you, students, for watching me. In next video, we continue acid topic, and in that topic, we continue the preparation of acid, students. Thank you for watching me. Thank you.